guys, it's Kritika. Welcome back to my channel. In today's video, as you can tell from the title of this video, I'm going to be sharing with you what I have on my iPad. So every time I put up a video where I show my iPad, a lot of you guys ask me to do like a detailed review of my iPad, ask me what iPad I have, what apps I use and how I use my iPad. So I'm going to be covering all of that in today's video. So the iPad I have is the iPad Air 3. It's super lightweight, very sleek, and I've almost had this for a year now, and I also got an Apple Pencil with it. So when I bought the iPad, I really wasn't sure if I should buy it or not because this isn't something I really needed for my work. It was more of an indulgent purchase. But now, having used it for almost a year, I have to say that this is hands down my favorite Apple product. I love it so much, and especially with the pencil, this whole combination is just so useful, and I'm going to show you in this video what all I do with my iPad. So let's get started. So first things first, this is the home screen. I basically downloaded this picture from Pinterest, and clearly I'm missing traveling a lot, and I love sky photos in general and sunsets. So I really like this picture. But as soon as you unlock, this is what you see. So I only have two pages for my iPad, but starting with page one. So on the side here, after the new iOS 14 update, I've added a bunch of new widgets here. So I've got the calendar here. Over here, it shows me the battery of the iPad and the pencil. And I've just added a couple of photos I downloaded from Pinterest that inspire me. So page one has a lot of like these Apple default apps and also like the apps that I use the most. Now, before I talk about all the apps on my iPad, I just want to say that I actually love trying out new apps. I'm obsessed with like productivity apps, all these creativity apps like photography, video editing apps, doodling apps. So those are the kind of apps I have on my iPad, and I've tried a lot of apps, and I'll tell you which ones I like the most. So on the first page, we have the apps which come default with the iPad, and also some apps which I use the most. So I'm gonna skip the first three lines here because those are just like the default apps and not super interesting. But coming to the first app, which is an app that I spend at least an hour on every day, is Goodnotes. So Goodnotes is a note-taking app, and I basically use this to write down everything possible. So I have my journals on this. I have different notebooks for YouTube ideas, random ideas I have for online courses that I do. If I want to take notes, I have that here as well. So as you can see, I have different folders that I've created over here. So for example, if you go into journal, I have a bunch of different, as you can see, a lot of journals. I don't write in these journals every single day. But yeah, you can basically have unlimited notebooks on this. I'm going to create a new notebook and show it to you. So you click on new notebook, and it allows you to choose like a cover for your notebook. They have quite a lot of options. So for example, if I want to go with this one, I can also choose the kind of paper I want. So they have dotted paper, which is what I usually use, but they also have like square paper, ruled, calendar view. You can have like a monthly calendar here. So I'm just gonna go with dotted paper, and let's call this iPad video notebook. So this is what the notebook looks like when you open it. This is the cover page, and this is page one. You can add as many pages as you want. So for example, I want to write something about what's on my iPad video script. So I can write down whatever I want. I can highlight stuff. I can create as many pages as I want. So this is amazing to like take notes. This is one of those apps that makes me wish I was a student, and I've honestly started doing so many online courses, I think in a way because of this app, because I write down all my notes, and the Apple Pencil is just so nice to like write with. It honestly feels like you're writing on paper, but even better. So I really love the Apple Pencil. You can honestly do a lot of things on this app. You can import PDFs, or if you have like documents that you want to read or books you want to read, and you want to mark stuff on it, you can import that and write stuff on it. So super useful app. The next app, which is my second most used app, I think, is Procreate. So a lot of people keep asking me how I create my thumbnails where I'm writing stuff, or how I created the Draw My Life video where I drew everything, and how I add handwritten fonts in my video. So Procreate is the app I use for that. And this is basically a really professional app for all kinds of sketching and doodling and stuff. So I'm not very pro at it, honestly. In fact, only during this lockdown did I start learning how to illustrate and stuff. So this is what my Procreate looks like. All of these illustrations you see here, I did that myself. This is something from one of my online classes on illustrations. I also created sketches. This is of my friend Shreya, which I think looks really cool. So let me give you a tour of how Procreate works. I feel like that could be a whole video on its own. So on this app, you have so many types of brushes. You can also download brushes online, and You can pick the color here, and on the side you can increase or decrease the size of the brush and reduce the opacity. And this is what it looks like. So pretty cool. There's lots of uses of this app, and of course I'm not like a pro illustrator. I mostly just use this for fun or for my handwritten fonts on YouTube, but this is an app that I love so much. The next app is called Notion, and it's something I only downloaded 3-4 days ago, but I'm already obsessed with it. So this is like the ultimate productivity app. If you wanted an app where you can take notes, make lists, have your calendar, link all of those things together, you can do all of that on Notion. So I'm still getting the hang of this app because there is a bit of a learning curve involved, but let me show you what it looks like. So as you open it, okay, this is my habit tracker. I already had it open, but on the side here, you can see I've created a bunch of different pages. Some of these are just templates I found online for free in other people's videos. So I'm trying those out, but I have my weekly agenda. This is a template I'm just trying out. So for example, if I want to add Monday, film, a video, edit. So like that, I can just add different things on my weekly agenda and just plan my week in advance and check things off as I'm done with them. So I'm trying out a bunch of different templates. Another one which I found online, which was in Thomas Frank's video, I think, is this YouTube planner, which is just so amazing. This is what that whole template looks like. So for each video, you can literally have every single detail listed out over here, and all of these items can also be linked to different pages within Notion. So for example, you click on this, there's a whole separate page for that particular b-roll shot. So this is just something I downloaded off the internet. I'm trying out this template. There's honestly so much you can do on Notion, and I'm on the free plan, which seems to be enough for me. So you don't even have to pay for this app, and I'm just very excited to get organized in life. I love productivity apps, and I've honestly been searching for like the perfect app, and I think Notion comes close. So quite excited about this app. I feel like there's so much to explain about Notion, so I can't fit all of that in this video, but if you want a separate video where I explain how I organize my work and everything, let me know and I'll be happy to do that. Next, I've got my Google Calendar, which is where I plan my daily schedule. Then I've got this app called Zen Flip Clock, which is the clock that you saw at the start of my video. So this is my screensaver on my MacBook, and I really like it. Unfortunately, you can't have this as your screensaver on the iPad, but they have a separate app. So what I really like about this app, apart from how it looks, is that it has something called the Pomodoro Timer. So this is what it looks like when you swipe right. So if you don't know, Pomodoro technique is basically this productivity technique where you work for 25 minutes nonstop and then take a 5-minute break. So I like to keep this on my desk on the side as I'm working so that I can track how long I'm working for, and I really like using this app for that. Next, I've got this app called Insight Timer, which basically has a lot of guided meditations. So if you're someone who's trying to get into meditation, this is a great app. The next app is called Sweat. I've spoken about this before. So this is the app I used to use for working out, and in fact I still use it, but my subscription just expired last month and I was taking a break from this app. So I'm gonna renew my subscription soon, but this is just my workout app. Now moving on to the second page. Now here I've organized everything into folders, and I've tried to add like icons to the folders as well just to make it look cuter. So the first folder is Essentials, and this basically has all my native iPad apps that I don't really use. So I've just dumped them there because I may need them sometimes, like for example Zoom, I do need that. But this basically has a lot of boring apps. Next, I've got my watch folder, which has Netflix, Prime Video, Hotstar, and Boot. Usually I just watch things on my laptop, but at night when I'm in bed, I think the iPad is just like easier and smaller to work with. Then we have the social folder. Now I don't really use social media much on my iPad. I usually just do that on my phone, so I don't have Facebook and Twitter and all these other apps, but I've just got Instagram, Pinterest. Pinterest is an app which I love using, so I've also been pinning a lot. In case you want to follow me, I'll leave a link, but this is what my profile looks like. I've been using Pinterest quite a bit during this lockdown and loving it. I've also got YouTube and YouTube Studio, which is basically for analytics and stuff. Next, we have the sketch folder. So Procreate is the app that I use the most for sketching, but I also have all these other apps. Now, obviously I don't use all of them, but some of these apps have nicer features than Procreate sometimes. So let me show you like a couple of apps that I like. So Adobe Fresco, I really like this one particular brush on that. Basically, it has like these really nice, pretty watercolor brushes which have like the exact water paint effect. As I'm drawing, it kind of just like fills it in like it's real paint. So I think this is such a cool paintbrush. I use this app literally just for this paintbrush. All the other apps, honestly, I kind of just have them, but I don't really use them. Next, we have the design folder. Now, in this folder, I have apps that you can use to create cool posters and Insta stories and stuff. So the first one is something I use a lot. It used to be called Story Art, but now it's called Artery. And as you can see, it has a lot of really like cool Instagram story templates. So a lot of times people ask me how I create my Insta stories. Usually it's just off Instagram, but sometimes if I want to make it look more aesthetic, like for example, look at all these like cool templates that they have. So you can just replace their photos and add your photos instead. So this is an amazing app if you're a creator. Another app from this folder that I use a lot is Canva. So a lot of people create YouTube thumbnails on Canva as well, but I mostly just use it for like cool graphics whenever I need to create them. You can create presentations, infographics, flyers, posters, literally anything you want. I think Canva is one of the best design platforms, and I'm sure you've heard of it as well. The other apps in this folder, I don't really use them frequently, but I still do use them every now and then, so I have them on my iPad. The next folder is probably my favorite. It's called Productivity, and I think I've tried out so many productivity apps. And like I mentioned earlier, Notion is by far my favorite, but I've only used it for 3 days, so it's too soon to tell. But here are some other apps that I use. So there's this app called Post-it, which I like the idea of this app, so I have it, but it is kind of counterproductive because you have to go on this app to like see these Post-it notes. You can't just attach them to your homepage. But anytime you want to like make note of something, like write down your to-do list, you can just like write it on different Post-it notes and save it. And unfortunately, you have to open the app to like look at it, so it's kind of counterproductive. The next one is called Day One. Now, this is a journaling app which I tried using and I didn't like it too much, but I didn't delete it because I've been hearing good things about it, so I thought I'll give it a shot. The next app is called Xenia, which is quite a nice app. So I use this for journaling and I only have one journal on this, as you can see, the essential one, but let me show you what it's like. So if you create a new journal, they have pre-made templates for journals. So click on this, and a lot of these templates are free, so I'm still using the free version. So for example, if I want the joyful planner, so this is what the planner looks like. I actually really like this template. I think I'll start using it. The next app is called Bear, which is a productivity app that I've been hearing a lot about. I tried it out and somehow I didn't like it too much. Next, we've got Pocket. Now, this is an app I've been using for 3-4 years now, I think. But you know how sometimes you come across articles which are really interesting and you want to read them, but you don't have the time to read them, and then you just never end up reading them. So whenever that happens, you can add those links to Pocket and all your links will be saved here. You can also organize these into like different lists. So this app is great for that and something I use very frequently. Next, we've got Evernote, which is again a note-taking productivity app, which I used to use a lot before, but now I feel like the iPad Notes app itself is really good. And lastly, I've got Shopify. I've been building my online store on Shopify, so it's for that. The next folder is for photos. Now, I have a lot of photo editing apps, but the app I use the most is Lightroom, which I have made videos about before. I also have my own presets, which I sell on my store. So all my photos, I mostly just edit on Lightroom, and I just love everything about this app. So I've got all my presets installed over here, and with just one click, you can get some really cool edits for your photos. So in case you want to check out my presets, I'll leave a link in the description. Apart from this, I kind of use all these other apps, but not really for like the main photo editing, but each app has like some specific features which I like. The next folder is for video. Now, these are the 4 video editing apps that I have on my iPad, and this is mostly for editing like Instagram videos, Instagram reels and stuff like that. So I usually use InShot just because of how easy it is, but all of these other apps are really nice as well. And of course, for my YouTube, because most people keep asking me, I use Final Cut Pro on my laptop. The next folder is called Learn, and it has all my learning related apps. First, I've got Masterclass, which sadly my subscription expired a few months ago. Skillshare is another app I use a lot. That's where I've been learning illustrating, and they have a lot of courses on different creative fields. So be it filming, photography, doodling, stuff like that. Duolingo is where I've been learning Spanish. So I was quite diligent the first couple of months, but honestly, lately I don't do it as often. Then I have my Kindle app. Again, I don't really read on my iPad. I usually just read on my Kindle, but useful to have the app anyway. The next folder is for podcasts. So I use the Apple Podcasts app, Overcast, which is my favorite app for podcasts, and Spotify. And last folder is called Fun, but honestly it just has a bunch of random apps. So the first two apps are coloring books. I like Pigment more than Colorfy, but both of them are paid apps. They only have like a few free paintings, so I haven't really paid for it yet. But it's a lot of fun to use when you're feeling stressed out. So for example, this is one of their free templates. The cool thing about this app is that once you start coloring in a particular section, even if you go outside, it still like stays within the lines, so your coloring can be like a lot neater. Then I have Ludo King, which is like my lockdown guilty pleasure. I've got GarageBand, which just came with the iPad. I don't really use it. And the last app is an app that I recently discovered and I've been loving it so much. So lately I've kind of been struggling to fall asleep at night, and this is the app that I've been using during my sleep time. So they have like a bunch of different settings, like you've got focus, sleep, nap and breath, but I usually use the sleep mode. So you can go on this and set like an alarm, and you can choose different sounds that you want playing and that will play for a while. And these are really like relaxing sounds, so they put me to sleep. And then the alarm tone is also the same music, so it's quite calming rather than the really horrible alarm sound that I normally use. So these are the different sounds that they have. They've got like a storm, the rain, I don't know if you can hear it. There's this calming zen music. So yeah, that's something I've been using a lot recently. And with that, we come to the end of this video. I can't believe how long this video is, because I didn't think it would take so much time to explain what all apps I have, but I hope you enjoyed watching this video. I know in this video I just kind of like quickly skimmed through the different apps I have, but some of the apps I have, I honestly love using them so much, and I could totally make like a whole video about those apps, like Notion and Procreate. So if you'd like to watch that, let me know. I think ever since I got my iPad, I've honestly stopped using notebooks. I don't buy notebooks anymore, and it's really convenient because especially when you're traveling, which hasn't happened this year, it's easy to just have this device rather than carry all your different notebooks for YouTube ideas and stuff like that. So this is super convenient. So with that, I'm gonna end this video. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, give it a like, leave a comment, let me know if you have any app recommendations for me, because I'm always looking out for like new interesting apps to try out. Subscribe to my channel, press the bell button, and I will see you guys next time. Bye.